City leaders tell me the levees were built a few years after the record-setting floods way back in 1945, but they've never been tested like this before. Now, the section they're keeping a close eye on is several miles from here, but the emergency manager says if it fails, it could affect parts of Van Buren.
This picture shows a National Guard helicopter dropping rocks and gravel to help reinforce the section of levee in Crawford County. Emergency manager Brad Thomas says it's surrounded by farmland, but a handful of people do live nearby.
It is an area of concern, but we are watching it, and that's the reason why we wanted to be proactive and let people know in case, just in case, precautionary measures that there was a breach of the levee. We wanted people to be notified so they could be prepared in case they needed to evacuate.
You can see the water seeping up from the ground in this picture. Thomas says it does not indicate the levee is about to fail.
That doesn't alarm the Corps. I think people take that the wrong way when they hear seepage, because it's actually the water table on the levee side, on the dry side of the levee. That's the water table rising because there's so much weight on the river side of the levee.
But if the levee did fail, water could come rushing in and people would have to hurry to immediately evacuate the area. Thomas says the water would also start to backfill into parts of Van Buren.
We're talking 2 to 3 days before it could even reach, and only a very small portion of Van Buren would be affected in between Industrial Park Road and the levee.
In Crawford County, there's 26 miles of levees. Until now, they've never held back so much water for so long.
No, they have not been tested like this before, and there's going to be force on these levees for quite some time.
And the Corps of Engineers says it could be several weeks before the floodwaters recede. Now, here in Crawford County, someone is checking on that section of levee once every hour around the clock. They're also using a helicopter to survey it by air twice a day, except when the weather makes it too dangerous to fly. Live in Van Buren, Brett Rains, 4029 News.